This video is brought to you by iInvest.
Have you ever heard the saying, do not put all of your eggs in one basket? Well, this concept mostly applies to the financial world, and it basically means that whatever happens or whatever you might plan to do, never try to rely or put all of your trust in just one thing, especially when it comes to finance. So in this channel, we talk mostly about stocks and maybe a little bit of binary exchange and maybe, you know, somewhat a little bit of crypto as well, which I'm planning to even talk about more on this channel. I'm mentioning all those in case you're new to the channel. We actually talk about personal finance and personal branding on this channel. So I noticed that we are kind of limited to what we talk about on this channel, but today, thanks to the sponsors of this video, iInvest, I'm going to share even more financial instruments that you could be able to put your money in while you're busy with work, hustle, or business. Your money could be working for you instead of you having to work for your money. Well, in short, that's actually what investing basically means. So just join me and let's go ahead and start this video. Hey, what's up guys, and welcome back to the channel. As always, if you're new to the channel, my name is HARIS, Kari, and if you're a returning subscriber, thank you so much for coming back. So what we basically talk about on this channel is personal finance and personal branding. So if that sounds like something interesting to you, go ahead and smash the red subscribe button right there and make sure you join the family so you don't miss any video from me again. And so that being said, let's get back to the video. So if you're new to the channel, as I said, we talk about personal finance and personal branding. In other words, that is learning multiple ways to create income for yourself so you won't just have to rely on just one source of income. And one of the topics we mostly talk about on this channel is stock market. So I guess one video that I have talking about the stock market happens to be the most viewed video on this channel. That is to tell you that stock market really is growing, and I never really thought that video would get to that much views, but yeah, it is at that much views right now. But the thing is, today I want to introduce even more financial instruments that we can be able to use, or we can be able to put our money so our money can work for us while we're hustling out there working our 9-to-5, or maybe, you know, in the market doing our businesses, or maybe at home doing our businesses from home. So right before we start that, let's go ahead and give a warm kudos. So welcome to the sponsors of this video. They made it possible for us to talk about this. So today I'm going to be introducing this app that I know most of you have heard of already, or some of you might have not heard of it yet. And the app is iInvest. So I'm going to be introducing a lot of cool stuff about iInvest, and I'm going to be showing you step by step, because this is going to be an app review. You know how we do our reviews. So I'm going to take it step by step, show you every single bit of things that you need to learn, or maybe you need to know about this app in order to use it, or maybe to start using today. So without wasting any more of your time, let's just go ahead and start the review right now. And in case you're new to the channel, we always have links in the description to download the apps that we review on this channel. So go ahead and check the description of this video to find the link to download this app. So let's begin. So now, first and foremost, I just wanted to point out this. I don't know about you guys, but I am a fan of colors. I love colorful stuff, and to be honest, color purple has always been a color that stands out for me, and I really love the color. So that I can say that is the first thing that I love about iInvest. I love the color of the brand. So if you don't have an account, go ahead and register. You know, it's not that difficult to do that, you know, because I guess if you're going to have to register on the video, it's going to be a very long video, but you know, go ahead. It's just simple English and a little bit of stuff. So anything you don't understand or anything you don't get, go ahead and let me know in the comment section so I can be able to assist you to finish registering on this app. So now, once you're in the homepage of the app, the first thing that you might want to do is to go ahead and click on the profile right there. So as you click on the profile, you can be able to see the personal information. So go ahead and click on the personal information, fill in all the remaining details that you haven't yet filled during the registration, because you know there might be some few things that they might still need to know about you before you can be able to use the app. So go ahead and fill it up, you know, all the things that they might need. Again, if you don't trust the BVN stuff and everything, you don't have to register. But if you do trust that, then you can go ahead and do that, because most of the financial applications nowadays need your BVN to be able to verify that it is you and not a robot using your account. But also, to the regular people who have always been on this channel, they know that I only review applications that I believe are trustworthy, or applications that are legit or legal to use. So if applications are not really legit, I don't usually review them on my channel. Or maybe if I review them, I will let you know that I don't trust the app, or maybe I'm not sure about the app, but yeah, I really trust this app as well. So you can go ahead and do everything right here, fill in everything that you might need to fill in. And once you're done, you just click on home and go back there. So the next step is for you to come down here. As you can see, there's a complete your profile right there. I still haven't finished completing this profile because I was waiting for you guys to come on this video so we can be able to finish everything together. I guess without finishing your profile, you might not be able to fund your wallets or maybe even be able to do anything. So let's just go ahead and check and see what they have for us in the complete profile so we can be able to do that. So as you can see, the first one is the profile information. I've already saved my profile information on the app. So the next one is the KYC document upload, next of kin and bank information. So let's go ahead and just finish all these things. I guess I don't have to show you how you do it, so just go ahead and click and do everything yourself. So let's just fast forward after I've already finished the whole documentations and everything. You guys should also do the same and let's continue. So voila, now we're done with the whole confirmation and registration on this app. So the next step would be for us to just, you know, go through and see what we have on the app before we even fund our account or fund our wallets to even start buying what they have on the app. So let's just go through and see what they have. So let's skip the fund wallet. So let's click on invest. So as you can see here, there are a bunch of products that they have right here that we can be able to, you know, maybe put our money into and let our money work for us. So let's just go ahead and list them down. So right here, the first one is equities. So in case you don't know what equities are, let me just click on it. Equities are just like shares, are just like stocks that we always talk about on this channel. So as you can see right here, an equity investment is money that is invested in a company by purchasing shares of that company in the stock market. They carry no fixed interest. Value can be created from a rise in the value of the shares and or from dividends. So as you can see clearly, these are stocks. So stocks are also called equities and they're also called shares and they're also called a lot of other names. So the thing is, you could actually buy shares on this app as well, just like the other stock marketing apps that I always talk about on this channel. So you can also buy stocks from this application, but that's not just what they have on this app. So let's go ahead and click back and see other stuff that we could be able to invest in on this app. So as you can see, there's also treasury bills. So let's click on treasury bills and see what treasury bills are. So let's click on the eye right there. Treasury bills are short-term debt instruments issued by the federal government through the central bank to provide short-term funding for the government. So as you can see, guys, this is a debt financial instrument that you could be able to, you know, loan out money to the federal government, and you know, they do stuff like they invest the money and stuff like that, and they give you back your money, you know, with interest or maybe profits on it, and you can be able to, you know, gain something from it. So yeah, I know a lot of us don't really trust the federal government and stuff like that in Nigeria, but nah, that's not me saying you shouldn't invest in that. You could actually try that if you could do that. So let's just go ahead and click on the next one, fixed deposit notes. So let's just see what fixed deposit notes are. Fixed deposit notes are an investment instrument which are provided by banks. They provide investors with a fixed rate of interest until the specified maturity date. So the thing about fixed deposit is that you actually put your money into a certain financial instrument and you already know how much you're going to receive at the end of the policy period, or maybe at the end of the maturity date of that contract that you just signed into. So you already know how long it's going to take and you already know the profit or interest that you're going to get on your capital. So you just get everything all together back to you, and in other words, to whom it may concern, that is kind of a halal investment. So now moving to the next one, which is fixed deposit notes USD. So just like fixed deposit notes, this is just you investing in USD instead of in Naira. And as someone who talks about financial stuff, I always tell you that it is always best to invest in USD than to invest in Naira. This is not me being biased. The kind of bad guys that always come to attack, you know, our Naira currency and stuff like that, things like inflation, which always leaves us, you know, at the loss. So the thing is, investing in Naira is good. Investing in general is good. But investing in a currency that barely fluctuates as our Naira does, I guess, is kind of a better investment. So now next on the list is the commercial papers. So let's go ahead and check what the commercial papers are. Commercial papers are an investment instrument which is provided by a bank. It provides investors with a fixed rate of interest until the specified maturity period or maturity date. So at least this is not the federal government giving you out loans or debts or stuff like that. So for those of you who don't really trust the federal government giving you a loan, or maybe you giving the federal government loans or debts, then maybe you could actually prefer to just, you know, go about the whole thing with the banks or maybe with private companies. Yeah, you could actually, I know you would trust them more than the just close them out. You know, I don't want to get into trouble, but yeah, let's just go ahead to the next one. Eurobonds. A Eurobond is an investment issued in a currency not native to the issuer's home country. So this clearly states to you that this is not issued in your own currency. So we don't have to, you know, be scared about investing in this one, because already we know that we're not going to be investing in Naira. So anyway, you can go ahead and read through the remaining thing and see, you know, it's all part of investment, so you could just learn one or two things. So yeah, the next one is insurance, life insurance. So guys, okay, insurance is a contract represented by a policy which provides financial protection or reimbursement against losses. So let me just confess something, guys. Well, the thing is, I actually have been working in the insurance industry for a while. So most of you might not know, but I have been working in the insurance industry for the past 4 to 5 years right now. And I can tell you that, you know, my time there working in the insurance industry was like the first time me being exposed to the whole insurance world and learning a lot of things about the whole insurance thing. So the thing is, it actually expanded my mind financially and, you know, risk-wise, protection-wise, a lot of other things-wise. So I kind of became more wise, you know, in that sense, if it makes sense. So I kind of learned a lot about the whole financial risk, you know, protecting my financial stuff, my properties, my belongings and everything like that. In fact, even protecting my life in general. So, you know, like stuff like health insurance, life insurance that helps you protect yourself, you know, in case of uncertainty, things happening without you planning for it to happen, you know, you're covered. The insurance company kind of like reimburses you back to the position you were prior to that incident happening and stuff like that. So there are a lot of things that goes into insurance. So insurance is also one good investment that you could actually make today that you might not regret in the future. But anyway, on to the next one. So let's click on savings. So savings, as you know, is just you saving something. But let's just read here what they say. Create savings plan. Save smart. Earn 8% per annum on your savings. You can save daily, weekly, monthly, or a specific amount at once. So the thing is, you could actually just create a payment method depending on however you want to, you know, be saving, maybe when you want to be saving, how much you want to be saving. They have already shown you how much you can be able to earn back, you know, as a profit or maybe interest on your savings. So without wasting my time, let's just move to the next one and see what we can do on this app as well. So the next one is bills. So once you click on bills, you can see right here, electricity bills, cable TV and internet. So electricity, you know, do the needful, put your biller, your products, everything. Cable TV, yeah, I guess they have, oh yeah, they have GoTV and DSTV. So for those of you guys, you know, all the Z World fans, the Starlight fans, you know, History Channel, whatever it is that you watch, you can go ahead and buy your subscription from there. And also there's the airtime top up and data top up as well. So as you can see here, MTN, Glow, Nine Mobile, Airtel and Smile. So yeah, Smile. So if you use Smile, you know what I mean. So let's go ahead, you know, can just go ahead and do whatever it is that you want to do. So the next one is transfer. So let's click on transfer and see. Okay, wallet transfer. I want to send money. So yeah, you could actually like send to your friends who are already on this app. So as you can see, yeah, my name is already there. I don't know why I'm seeing my name on my own account. But let's say I want to send money to myself. I could just click on this, you know, I want to send money to, I want to transfer money to this friend of mine on iInvest. And the thing is, as you can see right here, your friends on iInvest. I guess that means that you can only transfer to people who already have an iInvest account. So if you don't have an iInvest account, make sure that you create that account. You know, maybe I might decide to just transfer money to some of you guys, but yeah, I'm not saying anything, I'm not promising anything right now. But yeah, let's see. Easy wallet to wallet transfer of funds to family and friends on iInvest. As you can see, they actually mentioned it there on iInvest. So you can just go ahead and type in the amount here. Let's just say 10,000 Naira, even though I don't have anything in my wallet yet. So I can just, you know, add the phone number. That's the person's phone number, that's my phone number. Sorry, I'm not showing it there, but yeah, just click on transfer. But anyway, before we move to that, just go ahead and scroll down a little bit. We can see some of the recommendations here they're showing us. As you can see, there's a fixed deposit notes recommendation, some of the commercial papers, fixed deposit as well, treasury bills. And when you move down here, there's the stocks as well. So this is GTCO, that's GT Bank umbrella company, like the current umbrella company. The Sterling Bank, Fidelity Bank, Access Bank, like there's a lot of stocks. These are all Nigerian stocks, so you can be able to go ahead and just start buying with your Nigerian Naira in your wallet. So let me just go ahead and fund my wallet so you can see how the whole thing goes. So let's just say Naira wallet. So card payment, card payment, as you can see here, minimum amount is 150 Naira. So let me just go ahead and click on card payment, and I'll add the amount and just do everything. Let me just say I want to add 10,000 Naira. So let me just go ahead and input my card details and everything. So I'm just gonna go ahead and click on continue so we can see the whole thing. Yep, so here we go. I just deposited 10,000 Naira into my wallet. So as you can see right here, wallet balance 10,000 Naira right now. So I just deposited this into my account. So let's see, dollar, it's zero. So as you can see, you can actually like invest in dollar as well as you can invest in Naira here. So clearly you can see that up here. So let's see, something I want to invest in, but I'm not really sure what. So well, the thing about treasury bills, I guess, is you have to be investing in large amounts or sums of money for you to be able to enjoy the profit that you might be making from this. But if you're going to be investing in like 10,000, 5,000, I don't think you'll be able to enjoy this. But yeah, I think maybe I might want to do something else. Maybe I might want to buy a stock. Let me just go ahead and check through the stocks and see. So yeah, let me just check through GTCO. Wow, it's dipping and it's in the dip, as I can see, as we can all see here. So yeah, I guess maybe this might be the best time to buy a GTCO stock. So let me just see. So once you've already made a purchase of something here that you have decided to purchase, you can go ahead and click on portfolio right here, and you can be able to see all your investments, your savings, everything here. According to the graph, it will show you how much you put in investment, how much you put in savings, how much you put in whatever it is that you have already putting in the app. So the next thing is the news. The news right here tells you a lot about the financial market and stuffs that are happening, you know, currently, you know, maybe updates about stocks and stuff like that. So maybe if you might want to know updates about stocks, whether if it's best for you to buy the stock at the time or not, the news would really help you to, you know, kind of learn a lot about that and the current financial market happenings and stuff like that. And also guys, if you're not able to download the app, maybe due to like lack of space on your phone, just like my phone is always full, or maybe you know, the app isn't installing on your phone or something like that, you can always go to their website at iinvesting.com. that is iinvesting.com. yeah, investing without the I in the ing, so it's just TNG. That's investing.com. Go ahead and check the website if you really want to get it. In case you don't really have the app and you want to use it, you can go ahead and use the website. It's exactly the same as the app, so you just need to log in and just, you know, you'll be able to do whatever it is that you want to do. And that's one thing I really love about the app. You're not really limited to just the app. You actually use the website as well. So hey, beautiful people, so let me know if this video was valuable to you in any way, and also if there was anything that I mentioned that was kind of not that clear to you, or maybe you didn't really get what I said, just let me know in the comment section what it is, so I could try to maybe explain to you, or maybe just let you know, or maybe send you to something that you can be able to understand it even better. And I'm also going to make lots of more videos about all these financial methods that I mentioned that you can be able to maybe invest money into it, and I'm going to make subsequent videos to explain them even more in case you're kind of still confused on them, or maybe even after I explain them later you might still be confused about them. I will still explain them in subsequent videos, individual subsequent videos after this. So thank you so much for watching this video once again, guys, and also shout out to the sponsors of the video once again, iInvest, and I can't wait to see your reviews about the app. If you've already downloaded the app or used the app once or twice, or maybe you're still using it, just let me know in the comment section so I know that there are actually people that are already using this, and maybe, you know, maybe they might want to do a giveaway to you guys. Just let me know in the comment section, and thank you so much guys for watching the video. And if you're not yet subscribed to the channel, go ahead and click on the red subscribe button right there so you can always get updated anytime I post a new video about personal finance and personal branding on this channel. So guys, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the very next video. Peace.